So I finally got myself a Protech knife. Just came in the mail, and it's 12:30 on a Monday, so we got limited time to make this video and put it out. So this is going to be a real quick unboxing of this Protech. I'll tell you which one it is when we open it. But I've always wanted a Protech for a while. They're really, really good knives, and I hear a lot of good things about them. Never owned one, always wanted one, in emails and everything else. Never owned one, always wanted one, but they're expensive. So anyway, let's pop this open. We got the Blade HQ exclusive. Awesome. And the box, little magnetic deal here. I didn't open. This is how it came. So, you know, knife's right here. It's a small little knife. It's got your warranty information and stuff like that. Made in the USA. You guys know I like my knives made here in the USA, which is why you pay a little bit more for them. But, you know, I always, you know, if you're going to carry a knife, might as well be a good one. You can carry cheap knives or whatever, but they just don't last. So let's get this thing out of here. And this is the Protech Sprint. I might as well not hide that from you any longer. And it's an OD green. And it's looking pretty nice. It's a tiny, I mean, look at this thing. It is really small, you guys. It is an automatic, though, so check that out. Ooh, good lord. This thing is sweet, man. It's pretty sharp. So, I love how small it is. I don't like big knives. Like, here's a Spyderco Delicate, and that's considered a small knife, right? I mean, this is a tiny knife. This one's custom painted. I did that, and but it's, man, look at the size difference. Look at, it's just a tiny, tiny little thing. So that's one of the reasons why I like it, because it's small, it's in your pocket, just kind of disappears, and it's fast. You know, you don't have to, you know, flip nothing, do anything. You just hit the button, and there it comes. It is an automatic knife, so keep that in mind for wherever you live. Because in most states, they are illegal. But we're not going to carry it, right? It's just for show. Deep carry clip, which is one of the reasons why I bought it. I just can't imagine why knife companies do pocket clips like this. Where it's going to stick out of your pocket. And it's just annoying. No lanyard hole. Not a huge deal. I didn't really want one on this one. Most of my knives have lanyards, but we're good with this one. It's really nice and clean with the, you know, it's not real big in your face, Sprint. It's just real small. What is that? Is that like a serial number on there? Oh, I don't know, maybe. 661. Man, this thing is fun to play with. And they have this knife in all kinds of different colorations, pearl handles. I've seen this knife right here, not this exact one, but in like with the pearl handle. And titanium scales outside of that, and like a, you know, S35V, or maybe even like something even more premium than that, go for like $1,000 or more. So these Protech knives are really, really nice, and you know, they're expensive. This here, this little tiny little peanut knife was $130. So I got it on sale because normally it's $170. All right, it's S35 steel, S35 VN steel, which is a really good premium steel. I like how the main reason why I bought it is because, like, look at it. Like, that's a pretty looking knife. It's like a piece of jewelry. I'm almost scared to use it. Like, I'm going to carry this thing to work and be like, oh, do I even want to cut that with this? I'll probably end up using the, ooh, almost got me. Fun fact. If you play with knives, you're going to get cut. That's just a 100% fact. I'm just to put that out there. So something that's more familiar to people, probably a multi-tool. Not everybody knows. So this is the Leatherman P4. So that's how big it is to that. It's small. I mean, it's like a little bigger than my pink. Well, About a half inch, maybe an inch bigger than my pinky. Anyways, it's small, let's just put it that way. It's not a knife you're gonna get into a knife fight with, but are we getting in knife fights? No. We're not doing that. We're opening letters, we're cutting cardboard, we're cutting pizza boxes, we're doing simple tasks like that. We're not going out there sword fighting with this thing. You know what I mean? So no blade play. Let's see how it's centered when it's closed. Pretty good, right? Maybe a little off, right? Let me see. No, it's good. I'm just looking at it through the camera. Looking at how the center of the blade sits in there. It sits in there nicely. I mean, mainly because there's nothing pressed against it. So you'll see, like, some of the liner locks or knives like that, when you close them, and the knife will be more pressed up against one side. This one, it's just, you know, bang. It's really nice. It's got anodized aluminum scales. It's an automatic copper blade. Copper plated, I guess. I don't know if the whole thing is obviously not copper. It's copper plated because the steel is S35. So it's a copper plated, I guess, you would say. Automatic, California legal automatic knife. So it's not fully auto, which, I mean, I don't know. I don't even know what that even means anymore. You know, I know a lot of cops. I don't see a lot of cops going to be like, you know, you can't have that. Now, if you try to take this on an airplane, or you try to get to a government building with it, or a concert, or something like that, they're going to take it. You're going to lose your $150 plus knife. So, don't take it to places like that. Having it in your pocket, you get pulled over, they check you, they're not going to be like, oh, you can't have that. I mean, some cop could be a dick and be like, you know, whatever, but a California legal, whatever that means, I don't know, you guys can let me know in the comments, I'm not sure. In Pennsylvania, you know, all knives are legal. There's no, you know, how people are like, oh, it's got to be, you know, like this. That's not true. Everything's legal in PA except for automatic knives, but I don't think this is considered a full auto. So I guess whatever they did to make it not a full auto, I think it's like the ones that have to come out like straight. You know, I think because it's like more like an assist. You know what I mean? Anyway, but they label it as an automatic, so that's what I'm going to call it. I could be wrong about that. You guys can let me know in the comments. You know, I really don't know. Oh, and this is a serial number. So 661 out of however many. One thing that is cool that also I like a lot is the sharpening choil, which is right there, that little area, so you can sharpen the hole. Man, I should probably not do that. That just made me I just ran my finger that way and it just kind of was like really close. Anyway, that little choil right there will help you to be able to sharpen it. So since we're talking about sharpness, might as well. Obviously this thing's going to be really freaking sharp because it's right out of the box, but sometimes they're not, and it is. Maybe it's not too sharp, though. Oh, well, I have paper. It could be sharper. I'm not going to lie. It honestly, I probably have to give it a few passes. But, yeah, it could be sharper. It feels sharp, but it could be. It could be sharper. I mean, especially this side. Oof, this side's rough, man. This side's good. This side, though, yikes. So yeah, it could be a little bit sharper. That's a little bit of a disappointment, to be honest with you, from Protech and from Blade HQ. I mean, you couldn't give me a good edge. Anyway, really light. I like how light it is, and yeah, I'm gonna carry this thing around for quite some time, I guess, until I find something else. It's not really you're not gonna play with it a lot. You know, it's not one of those knives you can flip you around. It's just kind of something that's EDC friendly. You know, you can even just throw this thing in a side pocket, you know, up top, because it's that small. A coin pocket, I guess it's called. Anyway, so, you know, like I said, I'm not going to bore you guys with this whole knife video, just an unboxing, show you it. Show and tell. I have to get to work. I don't feel like going to work. I don't feel like doing shit, to be honest with you. I just want to lay here with my dog, play with my knife. What's she doing? Storm!
What are you doing, bud?
Huh?
What'd you do?
I know you did something. Talk to me. Talk to me, dog.
Okay.
What would you do? I know you did something.
Alright.
You're lucky. This time. So we found nothing that Storm was doing that was had anything to do with the video. Get out of there, would you? And that's it. Protech Sprint. Copper loveliness. That's gonna be it for this video. I'm not gonna bore you guys to death with this knife, you know, review and stuff. I mean, it is what it is. It's a knife deep carry clip. You guys know the deal with these things. You can watch Nick Chavez or something. You wanna learn the whole deal about it. I just think it's cool. It'll cut things. It's small. It's lightweight. Deep carry clip. Good steel. Fast. And I like it so far. So there you go. See you guys next time. Peace.